Hello, my name is Ruben Mesa. I'm one of the hematologists at the Mayo Clinic in Scottsdale, Arizona, and we'll be focusing on today's program, specifically new drugs in the pipeline for the therapy of myelofibrosis. We begin by discussion of the two JAK inhibitors in advanced phase 3 clinical trial programs. The first is pacritinib. This JAK2 FLT3 inhibitor was tested in early studies and found to have a differentiating feature of being able to be used safely in individuals with marked thrombocytopenia, and that it potentially could improve low platelets or anemia in individuals similarly afflicted while still getting improvement in splenomegaly or symptoms. We reported at last year's ASCO, persist one of pacritinib versus best alternative therapy in individuals who were JAK inhibitor naive with myelofibrosis, and found that pacritinib was superior to best alternative therapy for reduction of splenomegaly, for improvement of symptoms, and was able to be used safely in individuals with marked cytopenia. This agent went on a clinical hold based on concerns regarding safety and mortality on the study with the FDA earlier this year. Presented at this year's ASH upcoming in December of 2016, will be updated data regarding the second phase 3 study, PERSIST-2, that will further look at the safety and efficacy of this agent. In an aggregate, we'll try to help to delineate safety concerns, whether they were related to adverse patient selection based on inclusion of patients with marked thrombocytopenia, or whether there is a concern with the agent. Hopefully, all of this data in aggregate will be able to provide clarity regarding the use of this agent in myelofibrosis. The next agent, well along its path in development, with top-line data currently released to the public, are the Simplify 1 and Simplify 2 studies using momelotinib. Like the story with pacritinib, momelotinib was an agent that helped to improve anemia and potentially thrombocytopenia while also improving splenomegaly and symptoms. Simplify 1 was momelotinib versus ruxolitinib in JAK inhibitor-naive patients trying to seek improvements in anemia. Simplify 2, a momelotinib versus best alternative therapy, including those individuals with ruxolitinib, again trying to see differentiated improvement. Both momelotinib and pacritinib trying to be a resource for patients with marked cytopenia. PRM-151 is an anti-fibrosing agent. In early studies, helped to improve splenomegaly symptoms and fibrosis in combination or a single agent, those combinations being with ruxolitinib. On that basis, a randomized phase 2 study is currently ongoing, fully accrued, of different dose levels of PRM-151 to try to best characterize the impact and try to utilize a novel mechanism of action for treating these individuals. Imetelstat is a telomerase inhibitor, early studies tested by my colleague Ayelu Teferi, which demonstrated the potential of deep responses in a segment of patients with myelofibrosis. There currently is an ongoing phase 2 study looking at two different doses of imetelstat to try to quantify the benefit of telomerase inhibition in terms of cytopenias, splenomegaly, symptoms, fibrosis, and trying to avoid disease progression. Looking at these four agents, which are the most advanced in testing for myelofibrosis, it would envision that momelotinib and pacritinib have the potential of, in the future, impacting frontline therapy choices for patients with myelofibrosis, potentially those individuals with marked anemia or thrombocytopenia. Clearly, the phase 3 data will be important to analyze to see where they fit in the paradigm. All four of these agents potentially may play a role as second-line therapy for individuals that have failed or have an inadequate response to ruxolitinib. Now, whether the drivers of selection in one of these agents are cytopenias or other areas of resistance, again, more advanced phase studies would be required to best delineate that. Take-home points. Pacritinib and momelotinib have completed phase 3 clinical trials and seek a role on incremental benefit and safety in patients with cytopenias. Two, PRM-151 and imetelstat are the most mature of the non-JAK inhibitors in the pipeline of therapies for myelofibrosis. And three, second-line therapy for MF is certainly the most wide-open need, and any of these agents may potentially play a role in this space. My thanks to you for participating in today's program.